everybody, Beauty Fit Desi here, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make a quick 10-minute breakfast. Today we're going to have eggs with tomato and basil and a little bit of feta cheese. I'm also going to give you guys a special treat and show you how to make your own milk. And I am so proud of the fact that I can create my own milk. I don't have to go to the grocery store and buy it. If I want to, if I choose to, you can, but I'm a person who already eats peanuts and nuts naturally, so it's nothing for me to go buy, like, you know, a little tub of nuts and have some to snack and have some to make my milk with. So it's kind of like you're buying two for one. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started. Okay guys, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with our egg scramble. So I have one whole tomato. I prefer in eggs like a nice whole slicing tomato as opposed to like the little cherry tomatoes. In my opinion, the bigger the tomato, the better. I also have basil because tomato and basil just goes really well together and it's a nice herb. So we'll go ahead and get started by chopping that. So I do kind of like to dice my tomatoes as opposed to slicing them to have smaller equal portion sizes so that every bite of my egg scramble I can have a piece of tomato in it. And then as for my basil, like, I don't really cook my basil down too much. We're just gonna chop it and like we'll throw it in the pan at the end. But literally, like, if I wasn't talking to you guys, like, I would have been done chopping everything already. I love to eat brown eggs. I don't purchase white eggs anymore. I've heard that there are brown chickens and there are white chickens, but you know, well. Anyways, so I'm gonna go ahead and crack these eggs. And I noticed that the yolk in a brown egg is much fuller. Excuse me, it's much fuller. It's also a lot more more orange in the brown egg as opposed to the white egg. That could also be because I get organic eggs. I don't know if the white eggs that I used to use in the past, you know, they just weren't like organic, so that's why they look that way, but I just prefer my organic brown eggs now. As our olive oil heats up, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to make your milk. This is my favorite part of the video. I love making my own milk. It's so cool and literally it takes 3 minutes to do so. So what you're gonna do is take a blender. The ratio for your milk is going to be 1 cup of nuts to 3 cups of water. So today I'm gonna use almonds. And really, you can use just about any kind of nut you want. I've made walnut milk, I've made cashew milk, it doesn't matter. I have found though that the nuts that have like, I guess you could say skin, like they're not blanched. Like, you know how a cashew has like no skin, it's kind of like that white color, and but almonds are brown. I noticed that those type of nuts, like almonds and walnuts, you have to grind them up for just a little bit longer than cashews or peanuts. So I guess it's because like the skin of the nut is pretty thick. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and pour in 3 cups of water. And I'm gonna put the top on. Place that back here. Okay guys, so our pan is on a medium heat and it's ready for the eggs. So I'm actually gonna just pour them straight in here. And I usually just scramble my eggs in the pan. I really don't like take the time to scramble them. And me personally, because I'm a vegetarian, I do eat, I know you guys just saw me put 3 eggs in here, but I do eat the entire egg, the yolk and everything, because that's where a lot of vital nutrients is for your body. I mean, let me not use the word vital before my vegans come at me, but there's a lot of nutrients in the yolk of the egg, as well as a lot of healthy fats. And when you're a vegetarian and you're not consuming those fats from like chicken or pork or something like that, it's okay. Like, you know, it's not gonna kill you to eat the yolk. So that cooked extremely fast. So now what we're gonna do is go ahead and throw in our tomatoes. Let them sear just a second. We're not really trying to cook them. I just want to take the chill off of them and let them kind of marinate into the egg. And we'll go ahead and season it as well. So I'm gonna use some black pepper. I love black pepper. I have Italian seasoning, which is like a mix of like oregano and a few other herbs, and some garlic powder. Just a dash of garlic powder, not too much of that. All right, stir it all up. Oh, it smells so good. So now that we stirred our eggs, I'll go ahead and throw the basil in, because to be really honest with you, it's done. Like, it's really done. That's what I'm saying. Like, this is so quick and easy, but it tastes so good. And it makes you feel like, I don't know, you're eating at like a little cafe or something for breakfast. You're not just eating your typical eggs and bacon. It's a good way to have a nice, fresh tasting egg dish. And there's so many different ways you can make egg dishes. Like, you can literally mix an egg with anything. I've done it. The last thing that we're gonna add to our eggs are is feta cheese. You can actually, because you know how tomato and basil is usually with mozzarella, you can use mozzarella cheese if you want. I do have mozzarella cheese. I just wanted to finish using some of the feta that I have. And I love feta cheese. I love a cheese with a sour taste. I'm not really like a cheddar or American cheese type of person. I love Swiss. I love feta cheese. I love goat cheese, blue cheese. Yeah. So I'm just gonna go ahead and turn our fryer off and let it sit there, and it'll stay warm. And the good thing about eating a protein-based diet is that it keeps you fuller for longer. And I love to cook breakfast. I cook breakfast if I can every day. I try to make that the meal that I make so that I don't have to spend money throughout the rest of the day. If anything, I'd rather spend money on like lunch or something, but I am not spending $10 on breakfast. I'm sorry. Like, I'd rather eat 3 packs of oatmeal than spend $10 at Dunkin' Donuts. Sorry, Dunkin' Donuts. All right, guys. So for our milk, we're gonna go ahead and just turn the blender on. I have the 3 cups of water to 1 cup of almonds. And I'm going to put it on the highest power. Okay, guys. So our milk is done. You can tell when your milk is done by the amount of like brown particles that you'll see, especially if you're using almonds or walnuts. You'll see the skin of them start to dissolve and it won't look as chunky. But that's really it. And then you can have it with like a nice bowl of cereal and some bananas, and you have milk to go. And usually when I'm done with it, I just put it inside of this nice jar here. Smells like nuts. Okay, guys, so you just want to pour your almond milk into like a mason jar. Something that will contain it. And I think it's so cute, like having this little jar of like homemade milk. It's so cute, isn't it? Like, it's adorable. So guys, that was it. We made our eggs, we made our milk, and you can use your milk and your cereal of your choice. You can also use your milk and coffee. You can use it and oatmeal, whatever. It's milk, you know? So just like you would buy almond milk from the store, you have it here in your house. So yes, I'm gonna go ahead and eat this now because I'm extremely hungry. Bye. A bet. Wiggity wiggity wiggity.